With the Ford Pro Upfit integration system, you can create complex logic to support your upfits. Let's create a few examples of advanced logic using the logic tool. For the first example, we want to activate a strobe light when a soft switch is pressed and the engine RPM is below 1000. We also want to deactivate the strobe light if the soft switch is pressed again or the engine RPM is above 1500. Start by creating a new project and entering the project information. Next, let's create the strobe light soft switch. Navigate to the right-hand panel and select Touchscreen from the drop-down in the Vehicle Signals tab. Enable the touchscreen. Click Add Switch. Double-click the soft switch to open the settings. And change the name to strobe light. You can change the page position of the soft switch on the sync screen if desired. Select the working light icon and then close to save. Drag the soft switch and the status block to the canvas. Next, we need two instances of the engine RPM can signal. Navigate to the right-hand panel and select Can from the drop-down. Search for RPM and drag the RPM can signal to the canvas twice. Click the first instance and select When from the drop-down menu. Select the less than symbol and enter 1000 RPM. Select the second instance. Select When, greater than, and then enter 1500. Next, we need three gate blocks and a flip-flop latching block. Navigate to the right-hand panel and choose the Logic Blocks tab. Drag three simple gate blocks to the canvas. Drag a flip-flop block to the canvas. Now we want to connect the strobe light soft switch in the first engine RPM block to an AND gate block. Connect the output of that gate block to the flip-flop block set node. This will set and latch the power output until the reset is activated. Next, connect the strobe light soft switch to the second AND gate. Click the third gate block and change the condition to OR. Connect the second gate block output to the OR gate block on input 1. Connect the second engine RPM block to the OR gate block on input 2. And connect the OR gate block to a flip-flop reset node. This will reset or deactivate the power output for the strobe light in our example. Next, we need the power output block that represents the pin that is wired to our strobe light. So navigate to the right-hand panel and open the Connectors tab. Expand the power output section. Drag two instances of the power output block to the canvas, the one that we wired the strobe light to. Zoom out to get a better view of the entire thing. Connect the flip-flop to the first strobe light power output block. Last, we need to reflect the status of that power output onto the soft switch on the sync screen. So connect the status node of the power output block to the touchscreen strobe light status block. So whenever the status of the power output pin changes, it will be reflected on the touchscreen. Save changes and create your configuration to deploy to your UIS-equipped vehicle. For the next example, we'll activate and deactivate a beacon light when a hard switch is pressed. However, before activating, we want to ensure that the ignition is in the run state, the high beams are off, and the driver door is closed. To do this, we need to chain multiple gate blocks together, connected to multiple CAN signals as inputs. First, create a new project. Next, find and drag the CAN signals onto the canvas. Navigate to the right-hand panel. By default, it should display the CAN read signals. Search for and select and drag the ignition status, the headlight switch for the high beams, and the driver door status. For ignition status, select when and run. For headlight switch, select when and off. And lastly, for driver door status, select when and closed. To create logic for a hard switch in the logic tool, you need to wire it to one of the digital input pins on the UIS module. Navigate to the right-hand panel. Select the UIS Connectors tab. Choose Connector 3 from the drop-down, and then expand the Digital Inputs section. There are two types of digital inputs, active high and active low. Active high means the voltage is applied when the signal is high. Active low means the ground is applied when the signal is high. For this example, we want an active high input. Select one and drag it onto the canvas. You can also double-click to rename the block on the canvas to help you stay organized. I'll name this one beacon light hard switch. And close to save. Next, we'll need to drag three gate blocks onto the canvas so we can chain them together to define all the preconditions. The last block we need is for the power output that we wired our beacon light to. Navigate to the right-hand panel. Select the UIS Connectors tab. Choose Connector 2 from the drop-down. Expand the Power Output section. Select the power output that you wired the beacon light to and drag it onto the canvas. Next, we'll wire up the circuit. Connect ignition status to input 1 and headlight switch to input 2 on the first gate block. Connect the first gate block to the input 1 and driver door status to input 2 of the second gate block. Connect the second gate block to input 1 and the beacon light hard switch digital input to input 2 of the third gate block. And finally, connect the third gate block output to the beacon light power output. Save changes and create your configuration to deploy to your Upfit integration system equipped vehicle. Any questions? Visit this site for more information or email fpsvhelp@ford.com in Europe.